Good morning, students, and welcome back. Today we are going to look into again unit 2, where we'll be discussing about the storage devices, and specifically we'll be discussing about the alkaline battery and nickel cadmium battery. The course outcome for this lesson is to impart knowledge on various energy storage devices. And the Bloom's taxonomy level is apply level. The learning outcome would be at the end of this lecture, students will be able to gain knowledge on alkaline battery and NiCad battery. Nickel cadmium battery could also be called as NiCad battery. And these are some of the images of alkaline battery which we are using in our day-to-day life. So I'll be putting my discussion in terms of description, construction, chemistry, half cell reactions and advantages of alkaline battery, which will be followed by NiCad battery. The description goes like this. The alkaline battery could also be called as alkaline cells, and they are the improved dry disposable battery or rechargeable battery, because in dry cell the zinc can undergoes corrosion as well as there is leakage, which was improved in alkaline batteries by alkaline medium. That is how it got the name alkaline battery also. It is named so because it has an alkaline electrolyte of potassium hydroxide as opposed to the acidic electrolyte of zinc carbon batteries. And here, dependent upon the reaction between zinc and manganese 4 dioxide. So this is an improved dry disposable battery, and zinc is taken in powdered form so that it can increase the surface area of the anode, allowing more particle interaction. And also this lowers the internal resistance and increases the power density. We have a cylindrical cell contained in a drawn steel can, which is the cathode current collector. So this is the current collector. The cathode mixture is compressed paste of manganese dioxide with carbon powder. It is not only the carbon which is taken, but the manganese dioxide is taken along with carbon powder added for increased conductivity. The hollow cylinder of the cathode is lined with the separator. We have a separator here. The hollow cylinder is lined with the separator, and this will prevent the mixing of anode and the cathode. This is anode and this is cathode, and both are separated by a separator, and this prevents the mixing of anode and cathode materials and short circuiting of the cell. The separator is made of a non-woven layer of cellulose or a synthetic polymer. The separator must conduct ions and remain stable in even highly alkaline electrolyte solution. And anode is composed of dispersion of zinc powder in a gel containing the potassium hydroxide electrolyte. This prevents the gassing of the cell at the end of its life. More manganese dioxide has to be taken than what is required to react with all the zinc. So this is a construction of alkaline battery. We have a cathode, anode, a separator and current collector brass pin, steel can. So anode is zinc powder, cathode is manganese dioxide powder, and the electrolyte is potassium hydroxide. The half cell reactions are at the anode, as usual, oxidation takes place, which is loss of electron. So zinc will lose electron and it becomes zinc oxide when it reacts with two hydroxyl ions. So zinc plus two hydroxyl ions giving zinc oxide plus water, with the liberation of two electrons. And at cathode reduction takes place, that is acceptance of electrons. So two manganese oxide combines with water and accepts electrons, two electrons, and it is getting converted to manganic oxide with 2OH minus. The overall reaction is that zinc combines with manganese oxide to form zinc oxide and manganic oxide, and the electrode potential is 1.5 volts. The advantages are they have better low temperature performance. They continue to function in sub-zero temperature also, so they are better than the zinc carbon, or in other words the dry cell, and less leakage again than the Leclanché cell. And they are available in wide range of sizes like AAA, AA, C, D and 9 volt sizes. They are suitable for wide range of consumer applications, and they are absolutely made out from non-toxic chemicals, and no voltage drop and longer shelf life than dry cell because of alkaline electrolyte. Here you could see in dry cell we are using carbon rod, whereas here we use graphite mixed with manganese oxide. So alkaline batteries do not have carbon rod cathode, which allow to be smaller. The use of alkaline batteries, most probably they are used in toys. Next we are moving on to NiCad battery or nickel cadmium cell. It consists of a cadmium anode and a metal grid containing a paste of nickel oxide acting as a cathode. The electrolyte in the cell is potassium hydroxide. The cell representation goes like this, like cadmium slash cadmium hydroxide double slash KOH nickel oxide slash nickel. So this is anodic half cell followed by a cathodic half cell. When the NiCad battery operates at anode, cadmium is oxidized to cadmium 2 plus ions, and insoluble cadmium hydroxide is formed when it combines with potassium hydroxide, and it produces about 1.4 volts. So this is the construction of NiCad battery. We have a positive tap, a separator, pressed power negative electrode, jelly roll, insulating washer, and enclosed can. And this is the core, which is sealed with cover, and we have a vent ball and a cap. So at anode, cadmium hydroxide combines with two electrons, and there is production of cadmium plus 2OH minus. And at cathode, nickel hydroxide plus OH minus gives nickel oxyhydroxide plus water plus electrons. And the overall reaction is cadmium hydroxide plus nickel hydroxide giving cadmium plus nickel oxyhydroxide and 2 water. This takes place when charging. And during discharging, actually this is during charging and this is during discharging. So whenever NiCad battery works, this is the reaction what is happening. Cadmium combines with two hydroxyl ions to form cadmium hydroxide plus two electrons. This is during discharging, working. And the forward reaction is during charging. So the overall reaction is that cadmium hydroxide plus nickel hydroxide during charging, cadmium, nickel oxyhydroxide and two water. During discharging, cadmium combines with 2 nickel oxyhydroxide and water to produce nickel hydroxide and cadmium hydroxide. The current passed in opposite direction during recharging, or we call it as charging. The electrode get reversed. Cadmium gets deposited on anode and nickel oxide on the cathode. So this is the reaction what is happening during charging. Cadmium hydroxide plus nickel hydroxide. During charging, we get back cadmium and nickel oxyhydroxide. Because during discharging, cadmium is converted into cadmium hydroxide and nickel oxyhydroxide is converted into nickel hydroxide. The advantages are that they are fast and simple, chargeable, good load performance, smaller and lighter. They have long life than lead acid storage battery. It can be packed in a sealed container. The disadvantage is that they are more expensive than lead battery. Okay, relatively low energy density and environmentally they are not friendly. So, not much encourageable. They are used in calculators, electronic flash units, transistors, cordless appliances, etc. So the learning outcome is that from this lecture, students were able to gain knowledge on alkaline and NiCad battery. And I'd like to acknowledge the slide share. Thank you for your attention.